ladies and gentlemen, to some more Overwatch Nace action. Of course, my name, Daniel the Save One Mena, and I am on that solo casting grind tonight. Of course, we're going to be just watching some Overwatch, like I just said, and it's going to be on Oasis, I believe this is. So, it's just a capture the point type of map. It's going to be St. Clair College, who just won an hour ago. A little bit of an hour break as we head on into incoming traffic. But it's going to be versus Lebanon Valley College. Once again, St. Clair are on kind of their dominant spree, which is eliminating every single college left, right, and center. And they want to continue that spree here tonight versus Lebanon. However, can they do it is the big question. They're going to be going right on back to a map they know very, very well. See what the comps are looking like so far, because they are still in their spawn, so they can still change if they really wanted to. But St. Clair kind of going with the tried and true Reinhardt Zarya type of comp. And yeah, nothing really changing over on that front. Lebanon kind of pulling out the exact same thing, but their DPS and their supports are kind of different, where they have McCree as well as Baptiste for themselves. But the wall does go out from Maid, not really capturing anybody just yet, as now St. Clair converging on top of this little path. Yeah, on top of this little balcony for themselves. But already on the point itself is going to be Crypt, as he stays full HP. Imp now destroying something for himself, and also going to be trapping up the Reinhardt. He does escape for himself, though, which is actually pretty interesting. But no kills have gone back and forth just yet. Just very simple Overwatch play coming from St. Clair. There you go. Imp is the first one to fall over on St. Clair, as well as actually the rest of these members slowly going to low HP, but they have been alive for a little bit. So Yustin can heal if needed, and he is going to be doing so. Seymour also goes down too, but Yustin trying his best to just heal his teammates. Going to be doing so just for a little bit, but the opponent going to be nanoed. Or no, he's actually going to be nanoed. It's going to be Prince Swada that's nanoed, but he can't really do anything just yet. He's just going to be kind of staying inside of his own lines. Then Crypt and Prince Swada both go down for themselves to start off this point. Now, finally, there you go. The percents have started to tick over for Lebanon. Might be giving St. Clair a little bit of trouble over here on Oasis. We didn't see it actually in the last match where they were struggling too much, but still, Jub does go down, does have his Dragon Blade available for himself if he wants to use it at any point as well. We do have Seki? I don't know. Gonna be playing the Mei here. Does have Blizzard also available for themselves, but we also do have Zarya here on the point. Does have Graviton Surge available for herself, so could use it at any point if needed. Blizzard also does go out for the allies of St. Clair, I believe. No, they don't. It's the opponents. My bad, but doesn't even matter. Lebanon grab two for themselves. Jub now going a little bit crazy in the back line. However, Breakdown has been activated, and just the disengage potential. That's what I wanted to say. Disengage potential was there for Lebanon, and they also take three for themselves. Start off that point too. St. Clair College now on the point where they have not gotten any percents for themselves and can't really get onto the site either. They're finally struggling versus a college, which is very interesting to see too. Lebanon now allowing themselves to have an advantage, which is just, I guess, staying on the point, racking up the percents if really needed. St. Clair needs to reset with the mental reset needs to come through, but Seymour has made his way onto the point and actually ends up suiciding. So he went in a little bit too early and not really communicating with the rest of his team there, which is kind of weird, but the Maywall does go out just to try and stop anyone from getting any damage. Yustin does take one for himself as well. Jub taking one, but that's the hammer down in the back line. Lebanon has secured the point itself. And finally, St. Clair College seems like they have met their maker, at least for this first point. They have lost in the past, at least once from what I remember on stream, but it was a fairly close match. This one actually seems kind of like a blowout, at least for the first round. Very easy reset could come through from St. Clair that allows them to take these next 2 points, but Lebanon just looks so incredibly good for themselves as we look at a cinematic shot of Oasis. This map's super sick. What we see out of St. Clair is kind of the same comp to come through. Jub now switching over to the Hanzo, which is definitely an interesting choice for themselves. It adds a little bit more AoE within the comp of Zarya and Reinhardt, but it also adds a little bit more damage for themselves. Of course, Genji was pretty good with the damage, but I feel like Jub-Jub can literally play any DPS and he can be fine. But as now we start to get into the second point, it's going to be a fight for the top of the rafters. The enemy Zarya ends up going down to the floor itself, but we do have Prince Wada that did charge the opponent Reinhardt, and there you go. All of a sudden, St. Clair have taken the early game of the first fight for themselves. Seymour taking the third here of this fight. Now there's just three members of Lebanon that are remaining, and one of them is going to be the Zarya. One of them was the Mei. Mei ends up going down. Baptiste also going down for his troubles too. Jub-Jub picking up a double kill for himself. But that is just the rest of Lebanon backing off towards their own corridors, because St. Clair are taking over the point, as well as a very easy 10% for themselves. Marked. Now still going on here, Jub-Jub trying to create some backline shenanigans, and he's going to be able to do so with a couple of arrow shots towards them. Not really doing a whole lot of damage himself, but the Ash has now come down onto the field. And has provided a little bit of disruption for Jub-Jub, now sitting on 30 HP. But meanwhile, on the point itself, we do have Jub-Jub that has come back to the point. But Lucio takes out Yustin in the backline as well. Hey, there you go. Finally, Ashe doing something for her team. Seymour does take one for himself, but Ashe getting a triple kill for herself. Now wanting to take a look more towards Seymour, doing a whole lot of explosive damage. At least Grok has done so. But now on the point, has Lebanon take over? That's already 50% going into the favor of St. Clair, which is pretty good. The Lebanon are now starting their reign of terror on the point itself. Jub-Jub realizing that he's getting spectated as well. He does do a little bit of damage to the opponent. Reinhardt, that snipe was sick. That was cool. Now, St. Clair converging on the point of actually contested it almost a full. They're slowly getting themselves up, but Crypt and Imp going down early on in this fight is not good whatsoever. Had to look out for the opponent's ultimates, and maybe that's exactly what the full entire... the point was mainly for, and the attack from St. Clair was mainly for, it was to take care of your opponent's ultimates. Because you can see St. Clair, they've got four ultimates for themselves. They're key ultimates as well. Lebanon, though, have saved three for themselves. It's going to be one really nice stalling out of Lucio, one nice engage that comes out of Indiana, but then also Baptiste, which is a little bit of extra backline damage for himself. Seymour using the ultimate for himself, not going to really get anybody just yet. Jub-Jub does get one thing for himself, but that's two members of St. Clair already going down. They're the backline healers. That's not too good. However, on the point itself, Crypto does get one from his Blizzard Prince Wada, trading his life out. But at the end of that massive, massive trade, Bob takes one more for Lebanon, with the rest of Valley College completely holding the point itself. They are kind of really, really dominant here on a hold the point style map. And they're really looking like they are going to take this one. However, St. Clair College has pulled up multiple times in the past before and have really, really pulled together for themselves. But now on the point itself, we do have the rest of St. Clair trying to pull together. Crypt does take one for himself, which is already a really good start to the point. Seymour now taking the second here of this fight with no one taking care of Farrah just yet, but it is still all good because Prince Water taking care of the last tank is so, so beautiful. St. Clair now get to start their dominance as they are on 50% and going, but Lebanon Valley College are on 99%. One fight could do it for themselves. Once again, like I said earlier, St. Clair multiple times in the past have pulled together in those late game situations and have really pulled together. You can see it multiple times throughout the scoreboard where they have really, or not really even the scoreboard, kind of their history of playing this game where they have constantly come back from mini deficits for themselves. And we can see one more go on here. But Lebanon now with the push does get caught out, which is going to be the Reinhardt. Jub-Jub now trying to use the Doomfist to his advantage. Not going to be catching out any sorts of Pharahs, but does get taken down to zero HP. Tried to find a healing pack for himself, but doesn't really work out. Grok now on the point itself. Does get one for himself. Seymour in the backline trying to deal as much damage as possible. But you have Farah being that massive, massive nuisance. Prince Wada taking two for himself. We do have the Farah that is still on the point, does take one for herself. Yustin goes down, but a support for DPS is always so incredibly good. Hammond now on the point itself as overtime has hit the clock. And we have to wait to see what this player is able to do, this Hammond player is able to do, because he's on very low HP, does end up suiciding himself. He didn't want to give any more ult charges over to his opponents. But that's going to be Prince Wada just completely taking over this point. And there you go, St. Clair College with the comeback, able to take point number two. Not bad at all. Heading into round number three. St. Clair are now in the place where they are very comfortable with attacking. Constantly, over and over again, they've done so. I always love JoJo's playstyle because it feels like he's always kind of like that. You know what? If this DPS doesn't work, I'll switch. And he constantly does that over and over again within the fights, within a couple of team fights. But if a pick really works, then he'll just kind of stay on it. We ran into a bookcase, but it's all good. As we now take a look at what St. Clair are able to pull out here in this team comp. Literally the exact same comp, but JoJo still staying on the Doomfist, which is actually pretty interesting. Over for Lebanon, though, they are keeping their tried and true and putting Grok over on Reaper. And already that early game damage that comes out of Reaper is so, so prominent, taking out two in the process with Zarya and Reinhardt taking out the rest of the team. St. Clair have gotten aced. I've gotten team killed within the first little bit of this match. Now the timer gets to start for Lebanon. Once again, St. Clair able to pull back in the last match. Why can't they do it here is the big question. We'll take a look at this next round as we take a look at the full-on force that comes out of St. Clair that's already won for themselves as Grok does take down JoJo as well. Prince Wada getting trapped between an ice wall and the rest of a team as well. We have Crypt that tried to flank and wasn't really too effective for himself. Now the rest of Lebanon do back up. They realize what they have taken from St. Clair, which is just a couple of casualties. Now St. Clair has to back up as that percent timer is slowly going towards 50%. Taking a look at Seymour now trying to flank with the Zarya, trying to get as much ult charge as possible. But Indiana Jones does have his ultimate for himself if we want to take a look at Reinhardt. He does want to maybe drop down that hammer at some point. So far, not going to do it just yet, but does end up charging. Both of the Reinhardts end up going down, but Seymour going to be taken down in DPS. Start off this fight is absolutely massive, but Prince Wada does get hammered down. He's on the floor. He is nanoed as well, but takes one for his troubles, which is going to be the May. Two end up going down by the Zarya over on Lebanon, but hammered down goes down from Prince Wada. Takes down two, at least Yussin and JoJo both taking ones for themselves. As now the actual percent timer is on 70%. So Lebanon, even if they do end up falling, they have taken a lot of percent from St. Clair and going on to the attack now. Facing 77 HP, not all that bad if I was Lebanon. If I'm St. Clair, I do have a little bit of a mountain to climb, but they were looking so incredibly solid there in that last team fight. So we still have to look at what they're able to provide here for themselves. As it was a lot of damage they were able to provide. We have Mei that's entering the point now slowly on 250 HP. They've gotten walled off right now. A one-for-one trade does go down as finally the Icefall is able to draw. Prince Wada takes down one, but it's going to be Seki in the backline now with the Blizzard. Going to try and do as much damage to the opponents as possible as now we have Gronk over on the right-hand side that is taking down, or at least doing a lot of damage to opponents as possible as well. A huge, huge ultimate comes out of Reaper. Now taking back the point. St. Clair College have gotten the point itself to 50%, but now it's already at 82% for Lebanon. Now looking for that 100% mark as they want to try and take down the Titans that is St. Clair College. Prince Wada now trying to do some sort of flanking potential for himself. Does have the hammer down. Does have the earth shatter. If he wants to use that at any point, Blizzard does come out and it's going to be so far onto the opponent Reinhardt. Now, multiple members of Lebanon falling as Prince Wada goes on an absolute rampage. Now trying to capture back this point to slowly push back at the 50% mark is what they are going to be able to do now.
Hello. Hello there.
Jub now realizing the situation that he's in, where he's been playing this Doomfist and actually succeeding on it quite a bit. Still doesn't want to swap off of it. Maybe after the next ult charge, but even still, he's playing well on it, right? Crypto taking one for himself, two onto Baptiste. Now wanting to go a little bit more aggressive is going to be the side of St. Clair, where they absolutely love to push into their opponents and take as much damage as possible. But when you take as much damage as possible, you're forcing your healers to try and heal up as efficiently for yourselves, and they're not really able to do so, and Imp goes down. But now at 56%, St. Clair College have defended this point completely and are now closing in on the 90s. Gotta wait for Lebanon to see if they actually want to push down onto this point. And so far, you have the ultimate that comes out of Seymour, but it's the invulnerability field that goes down. And that's a huge team fight for St. Clair as they just wipe the board of Lebanon Power and they just go down. St. Clair College win game number one. Let's take a look at the MVP, or the play of the game. It's Jub. I believe it was in the last team fight too. Ended up getting a massive Doom Fist power, yeah, on the opponents. Boom. Takes down the immortality field. Gets a double kill? Yeah, he gets a double, no, triple. He gets a triple kill, but then also has massive potentials for themselves. Mutter Butter saying LOL in chat. That's toxic. But as we set up for this next match, ladies and gentlemen, of course, I'm on that solo cast and grind here over on the stream. So if you guys have enjoyed so far, hey, drop a follow if you haven't already. But we are going to be heading into the next map. We do have to decide what it is going to be. I believe it is an escort map, if my predictions are correct. But gotta watch out for it, because so far no one's saying really anything in the chat. They're all just kind of chilling for the time being. The last message that was sent was by Mutter Butter, and he said LOL. What was he laughing at? Kind of toxic. Maybe it's toxic, maybe it's not. But St. Clair and St. Clair style taking the series. They did Lebanon put up a little bit of a fight, right? And maybe St. Clair can't pull out their usual noob killing strats versus this team. We just need to wait to see what they're able to do on this next map. Yeah, so Crypto finally saying, all right, what's the next map? We got to get into this. We've been waiting for a minute. We got to start going. Please be Junkertown. I like Junkertown a lot, actually. I don't know why I like that map so much, but it's like a super, like, aesthetically pleasing map, but then also like super fun to watch. There's a lot of maps in this game that are just like, eh, it looks like other maps. But now they want to go on to Dorado. This is the one that actually, I think, gave St. Clair a little bit of trouble when they ended up losing. They had a very decisive defending start where they kept the opponents in the base. I forget who this was versus, but it was the only match where St. Clair actually lost the series. I think. Maybe not the series, but the game. Can't remember. But regardless, we're going to be jumping into Dorado really quickly before this very short pause. Both teams are ready, so we are going to be entering very soon. Thank you for your patience, everyone. Hey, thanks, Vels. Vels and Socks, thank you guys for subscribing to the old channel. Appreciate it. I get to be a real Twitch streamer for once and say thanks for the subs. But anyways, we jump onto Dorado, where we get to see the potential of this map and what St. Clair are able to do here on this site. A little bit of server lag issues. It's all good. We're going to get those resolved really quickly. Those usually get resolved within seconds or minutes, whatever. It's all good. But we get to still watch it. We still get to watch this match in all of its glory. It's going to be, I believe it's St. Clair defending first. And if you guys don't know the purpose of an escort map for whatever reason. I know that the Overwatch League always recaps as to what certain points do and how to watch each game to make it a little bit easier. It's an escort map. So you have to escort a payload to its destination. Very simply, you get to see the destinations on the top of the screen once the round actually starts. It's going to be Lebanon that escort the payload first. St. Clair's job, though, is to defend. And they want to try and put up the good old St. Clair defense right at the start of the point. It's going to be done here. But Lebanon, they've done their research going over towards that right-hand side, or our right-hand side, are currently dishing out a little bit of damage on our boys, the St. Clair squad. But it's just going to be a bunch of raining power that come through from Lebanon as well. Prince Wada does take one for himself. However, it's the rest of Lebanon that we have to worry about because they are slowly doing their reign of terror. It's Gronk mainly that is taking out his competition. And it's going to be the immediate start of the payload push. There are only two members that are actually on the site itself. So if they want to move it at the max speed, I believe three or four go onto it. I think it's three, though. But regardless, they are pushing this payload super, super fast. As the rest of St. Clair are now resetting and getting back to the positions. There are two main points of contention. For the actual payload, which is one underneath this bridge, as well as one that is around this main corner. And this bridge giving Lebanon a little bit of trouble, as now Crypto does want to do some kind of shenanigans with Jub Jub over on these balcony sides. Whole lot of damage going over towards the side of Lebanon, but right now they're just kind of waiting. They're just kind of waiting for the little flicks to happen. Jub Jub doesn't find anything just yet, as he does rope up to himself and does take one. That was sick. Jub Jub, what are you doing? That was insane. Crypto now trying to hold down that back line for himself and for the rest of the team. We're kind of that front line. He's kind of in the front line there. As they now wait for their opponents to actually exit the base. It's going to be the small pixel peaks. Never thought I would say that in a game like Overwatch where there's small pixel peaks. Definitely see that in a lot of other games, but Jub Jub trying to do his best. Now the rest of Lebanon being able to get onto the point itself. Does take down two members, but it's going to be off the back of Crypt that they end up getting stuck. But no, I speak a little bit too soon. The rest of Lebanon do sweep their competition, and now it's only Jub Jub and Yes and the two snipers over on this squad that are doing the most damage that they possibly can. Jub Jub does escape his situation alive. However, Yes and does not, as he was playing more in the open. Now it's going to be St. Clair's a chance to get back onto this payload, but Lebanon's chance to push this payload a little bit further. Let's see what ends up happening here. Also for the chat, the reason why I'm not talking to chat is because we're on a little bit of a delay. I think it's three minute delay. So I can't really respond to chat too much, but it's all good. Still looking at this match. St. Clair looking to defend their opponents, and they're actually doing it pretty effectively here. Lebanon not really getting past this market area, and now with 60 seconds remaining, you'll start sweating a little bit if you're Lebanon because they want to try and get past the market itself. That's the one thing about escort maps that I love about it, is that it can be super, super fast if the payload is only pushed to a certain extent. But we do have the rest of the point now being pushed itself with one casualty going down, but it's going to be off the back of Jub Jub that allows them to just try and chill out a little bit. But as we do see May putting out the most freezing for herself, Prince Wada also ended up getting nanoed, but not taking any casualties for himself. Prince Wada actually ends up going down as well. Imp is the second casualty to fall as Crypto is trying to keep the most on this point, and he ends up slowly going back onto the site itself. Now in a 1v1 situation, Crypto does take down Lucio, but not taking down anybody else. Crypto also ends up going down to the hands of Baptiste. Jub Jub now behind his competition, looking for any free frags for themselves, and is not going to find anything just yet. Once again, still, it's going to be off the back of Lebanon's Reign of Terror that they end up continuing to push different points. And so far, they have pushed past the first one, now looking towards the second, where they are looking for their opponents and their advantages as well. It's going to be off the back of a flame strike. That Seki takes a little bit of damage, but so far, they're okay. We do have Blizzard being activated on the point, but Deadeye has also been activated here. Crypto slowly trying to do damage to the enemy D.Va, but it's going to be off the back of the invulnerability field. That is not going to allow them to take down the D.Va just yet. Jub Jub does take one for himself, but it's going to be freezed up Mei as Grok ends up taking out one. Jub Jub still taking one for his troubles there as well, as he's trying to juke out his opponents, now trying to flick to literally anybody, but he's not going to be able to do so as he's on 5 HP and ends up going down 2. On the point itself, it's going to be Lebanon that end up running over St. Clair and taking this third or the second point for themselves. Usually it's really easy on escort maps to take up the second point as well. So nothing really too crazy. Now I'm going to slowly push the payload over to its final destination, but not before St. Clair says, hold on, wait a minute. Prince Wada now getting nanoed for himself. Doesn't actually take down anybody, but it's going to be off the back of Seymour and Jub Jub that allow him to be that distraction for his squad. Deadeye has been activated as well. Not taking anybody just yet as he does take down one. Now it's a trade of kills all across the board as we wait to see who the ultimate victor is going to be in the last little bit. It's going to be Lebanon at the end of the day as they do end up backing up. Now it's only Prince Wada. That is the last one on the point. Does he survive, though, is the big question, because he's actually being healed up quite a bit by Yustin. Yustin now being found out for himself, ends up backing up. I might have spoken a little bit too soon, ladies and gentlemen, as Deadeye has been activated over towards Gronk, but it's going to be blocked off. Jub Jub, Prince Water are able to hold the point off the back of Yustin's healing. St. Clair College might have just clutched up this point. D.Va Bomb not going to do anything over on the side of Lebanon. They've got to continue to hold as it's only 3 meters left. Crypto punching the heck out of Baby D.Va. Is that illegal? I am not too sure. St. Clair College hold this point. What? Score. 0-1. Switching sides. Oh my goodness. St. Clair hold at a spot where we never thought it would be held before. All we got to take it is to 2 points and capture the third. St. Clair's done it multiple times here in the past. But it has to be off the back of team play and pure communication. Yustin completely carrying that last fight, by the way. The way that he allowed Prince Wada to live, when I literally called it in the comms that he was going to die, was a thing that was majorly unexpected. Did not know Yustin was in the back line. Ana with a whole lot of healing towards her tanks is massive. Gotta watch out for that as we continue to go on in this series. As now, Lebanon gonna switch up their comp just a little bit. Nothing too crazy. It's gonna be a Sigma that comes through, as well as Gronk playing the Torbjorn. So a little bit of extra turret pressure. Jojo also gonna be playing the good old pirate ship type of comp. Of course, we cannot have an Orisa with it because she is banned this week. Kind of surprised that they don't want to go for a Sigma, but I'm just a caster. It's all good. Five, what do I know? Jub Jub not going to be going towards the Bastion since he realizes they don't have 2 shields and only that 1 shield. Being heavily reliant on a Reinhardt shield too is kind of a struggle. I'm going to yawn. I don't want to yawn during a cast. Don't do it, Daniel. This is not going to be my first time, but as we look here on Dorado, it's the push that comes through from St. Clair that allows them to continue their reign of terror. Jub Jub now getting into the back line of his opponents. Switch up his skin as well. This is actually kind of a cool skin. Seymour does take down the turret, which isn't actually that bad, but he wants to try and get a casualty. If he can get a member of his opponents, then that would be awesome. Jub Jub is now in the back line. Doesn't want to reveal himself just yet. I think he got revealed by someone, but I'm not too sure who it was. Sigma actually using his shield over towards Jub Jub, which kind of makes me think that they know that he's there. But it's going to be off the back of Torbjorn that allows Lebanon to just run through their opponents. Jub Jub does take down a turret for himself, but that's really it. Can't really get in the back line here. Crypto does go down as well. They realize where Jub Jub is at the end of the day, and he's just kind of, he's roaming the map. He's checking this map out. What does Dorado have to offer for himself? So far, nothing. Hasn't been able to take anybody down other than a turret. St. Clair resets. And look for a new angle to take here on this point. This was something that actually Lebanon struggled with a little bit, was taking this point past themselves. But it's going to be the wall that is activated for now from May. We have to wait for Jub to look for his advantage. But it's going to be a stun that comes out from Prince Wada that allows him to just do the most here on this point. Yasin also being takes down the immortality field, which allows the Reign of Terror to come through. But Lebanon going to be holding the site for the time being. Yasin now with one kill for himself, as the rest of St. Clair do end up going down. It's going to be off the back of Crypto, which allows them to live. And he ends up resetting for himself, now trying to eliminate the enemy Sigma, or just do a little bit of damage to him as the rest of his team comes through. Torbjorn now resetting on the point, going to be using his ultimate as well. A whole lot of fire being spilled all across the floor. There's a little bit of damage to them as well. Also going to be powering up himself and allows a double kill, a triple kill to go through, as well as two assists. Bronco's crazy there in that fight as well. Putting down a turret. I don't think he actually has armor in his kit anymore. This is how old I am to Overwatch. Is that I remember when Torbjorn used to put down armor for his team. Come get your armor. He doesn't do it anymore though, which is unfortunate. But getting back onto this point is going to be St. Clair. The Blizzard has been activated as now Seymour tries to knock down some shields. Does take down the immortality field. Now finally, there's the Reign of Terror that we know and love. St. Clair have taken down Lebanon Valley very easily. And it's all on the back of a Blizzard, as well as an Immortality Field Destroyance. But they finally push the point, allow 1 minute to be added onto the clock. 1:30, I believe, to be added to the clock. As now they start their push onto the final site. All they have to do is get the payload over to where their opponent stopped, and they end up winning. If they cannot do it, though, then Lebanon Valley have won the game. And we go to a game number 3. That is what we're looking at here, ladies and gentlemen. St. Clair on multiple occasions have been able to pull up for themselves, but Jub is on the flanks just trying to snipe. Not gonna do it just yet though, as now being put to sleep is gonna be Torbjorn, and he does take a little bit of a nap. Does get woken up though. Going back on his little killing spree. Gonna be slowly pushing up the point. It's gonna be the rest of St. Clair, as now they are looking for their advantages. It's gonna be the flux that comes through from Sigma that does knock up St. Clair, but he's not gonna die just yet because Prince Wada has all the healers in the world. But now one team has a flux. Hey, the other team can definitely have that themselves. It's gonna be off the back of Seymour that allows one kill to go through. Does end up trading kills as Crypto Imp go down, but Jub is on the flank. Does take down one, does take down two with the immortality field going down. Jub also going down at the end of the day as well. But This is interesting because now St. Clair have all fallen and are not going to be going back on that point anytime soon, at least within the next couple of seconds. We're looking towards this payload. Has to be off the back of some ultimates. Nothing being charged up just yet, at least over on St. Clair's side. Gotta wait for the key ultimates to come back online. Seymour ended up using his in the last fight, Prince Wada as well. Ride, but they are going to be moving the payload just for a couple of meters as Crypto actually finds a huge pick that is massive, but Jub has to get on top of this site to take down a turret, which is actually pretty decent, but needs to find more. Does back up to heal himself back up to full HP, but now with the flank onto his opponent, he's trying to find some pixel peaks for himself, but does get walled off for the time being. Also getting nanoed is going to be Prince Wada. Does take down one for himself. Now looking for the Blizzard Queen, which is Mei. Not actually going to find anything just yet. Jub is now finally on the flanks, getting one, getting two. Seymour now with three for himself. Crypto taking out the last turret for himself, but now wanting to secure the win is going to be St. Clair. They take Bull Series tonight 2-0 very decisively. Woo! Play of the game. My heart. Let's look at the play of the game. Yeah, this was like the four piece that he got for himself. That was one, two, three. No, that was an assist. Yeah, he got a triple kill, but then the announcer said a quad because he got an assist. That's it. There we go. What a night of Overwatch Nace action. If you guys have enjoyed Nace action over here on St. Clair's channel, then of course drop the follow. But I think that's it for our broadcasting team. Thank you so much, Baker, for hosting this, as well as Yeti for our observer. Other than that, my name has been Daniel the Save One Man. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your night. That's gonna be it. That's it.
We'll be right back.